In this four-part series, I'm going to tell you about the different types of abortion, who's getting them, why, how people feel after, according to research, of course, and what some of the different laws are from state to state. In this episode, we're going to begin with talking about just what the different types are. Hi, I'm Thomas, and I'm a sex researcher. In November of 2018, the CDC released their most recent abortion surveillance report, which covers 2015. Now, they reported that in that year, there were just over 638,000 legal abortions in the United States. This is a 24% decrease since 2006. Whether you call yourself pro-life or pro-choice or anti-choice or whatever, a decrease in abortions probably sounds pretty good. At least on the surface. What would be really great to see is a decrease in the need for abortions, which is something these numbers really don't break apart. Is the need for abortions in the US decreasing, or is access to abortions decreasing? Or have the numbers not really decreased because maybe the number of illegal or unsafe abortions may be increasing? Back to those recent CDC stats for a second. You should know that about 25% of those abortions were performed at or before 8 weeks, so still in the embryo stage. Over 91% of abortions were performed at or before 13 weeks, and about 7-8% between 14 and 20 weeks. Only 1% of abortions took place after 21 weeks. So as you can see, the vast majority of abortions are performed very early into pregnancy. Now I'm going to tell you a little bit about what the different types of abortions are. And there's two main types, medical and surgical. Let's start with medical, aka the abortion pill. This medication is in fact two medicines, two different pills. The first ends the pregnancy by blocking the hormone progesterone. Without this hormone, the lining of the uterus breaks down, causing the embryo to detach, thus terminating the pregnancy. The second medicine you generally take 1 to 3 days after the first pill. It makes the womb contract, causes cramping, bleeding, and the loss of the pregnancy, eventually expulsion. The technique can be used for up to 24 weeks of pregnancy. However, what to expect depends on if the pill is used before or after 10 weeks. If before 10 weeks, you can take both medications together, or you can take the first at the doctor's office and then the second 1 to 3 days later. It's most effective to wait a day or two between the first pill and the second. If after 10 weeks, it's a bit more complicated and requires the woman to return to the hospital for the second dose of medication. Now, this dose will be inserted directly into the vagina, potentially multiple times until the pregnancy is passed. The second type is a surgical abortion, which can be either vacuum aspiration or dilation and evacuation. Vacuum aspiration can be done up to 15 weeks. This is when a doctor will use a handheld suction device to empty the walls of the uterus. Usually takes 5 to 10 minutes, and people generally leave 30 to 60 minutes following. Dilation and evacuation is used from 15 to 24 weeks of pregnancy. A patient is placed under general anesthetics, the fetus is broken into pieces, and the lining of the uterus is scraped away. This usually takes 10 to 20 minutes from start to finish, and the patient is generally able to head home after 1 to 2 hours. For both medical and surgical abortions, if you're 23 weeks pregnant or more, it may be necessary to administer an injection into the fetus to stop the heartbeat. There are other forms of abortion, however, very uncommon and done in the third trimester. These forms of abortion are banned in most states and account for only 0.2% of all abortions. States where these abortions do happen are largely limited to protecting the mother's health should she continue with the pregnancy. But we're going to get into more of that in episode 3. The least common technique overall is intact dilation and evacuation. This is when the fetus is crushed and removed from the uterus. Although in the United States this procedure is rarely done, it is often the procedure that people who oppose abortion point to most and show photos of. It's also commonly referred to as partial birth abortion. However, that's not a term recognized by the American Medical Association nor the American Congress of Obstetricians and Gynecologists. In very rare cases where other techniques have failed or are medically inadvisable due to the health of the mother, a hysterotomy abortion is performed. This is where the uterus is opened through an abdomen incision, similar to a cesarean section. So that's what an abortion is. and what the current options are. Among the medical community, abortions are considered safe for women, and the CDC reports that only 6 women died from illegal abortion in 2015. Now compare that to the almost 23,000 that are estimated to have died worldwide due to unsafe or illegal abortions. And you're also probably familiar with the term conception, and people saying life begins at conception. Well, conception is considered to be the moment the egg is fertilized and cell division begins. However, it's entirely possible for an egg to become fertilized and not attached to the uterine wall, or attached to the uterine wall and then detach on its own. And it's also very possible for a woman to have no idea this has even happened. So who are the women that are getting abortions? And why? And how do they feel about their decision later in life? Well, I'm going to cover that in the next episode, and all according to research. So I'll see you then. Thanks for watching. I've got a lot of content in production, and I don't want you to miss out. So go ahead and click that subscribe button. And in the meantime, check out one of these other videos. And don't forget to send me your questions about sex to ThomasTalksAbout@gmail.com.